in on that, but I like the attempt coming out there as Hooney's going in. It's also going to be a play here in the mid lane. Oh! Jensen's going to be taken down. First blood goes over to Dignitas.
Amazing Orianna ball play there by Froggy. I'm getting kind of giddy because Dignitas is doing all the things that I want them to do. Hooney took two plates off bottom turret. That means Rift Herald charge will kill from there. Normally, it's really hard to get the fourth and fifth plates on turrets because of the resistance. MR has been building up so much. That turret is at 370 armor unless they reset. So on top of all the stuff they're already getting, they can get Drake after this too.
Diggs looking to take two. The turret hasn't gone down.
Ten of souls is if you're not leaning against anyone, it's harder to get souls.
Oh, Shurnfire. This is the kind of a play we were looking for. Hooney's got no way out. Chooses not to try to waste the flash there.
They pick really, at least in this game, they have very strong side laners. But initiation attempt.
There we go. It's Grig initiating onto Doublelift. He's going to be bursted down. The damage is there. Where's the follow-up from Dignitas? Doublelift is exploded. That's going to be a one-for-one. Core JJ barely looking to get himself away from this one. Impact going to be tanking up three. Make it four. Hooney's able to find him here on the side. Still looking to grab a little bit more damage. Let's be honest. Aside from Stoneplate Nautilus, there's not really a tank. GP ulti summoned up there. Dig looking to chase down Doublelift and Core JJ. Jensen and Impact will join up. Hooney's over the wall looking if there's an opportunity to go in here. Team Liquid will bring in the cavalry and the fight's going to break out. Turret placed down. Core JJ walking himself away. Redemption also going to be used now.
This is awkward.
Rig locked up. Impact's off to the side. The fight's freaking off in two different places at once. Core JJ looking to find the initiation. Gargoyle Stoneplate is used. Shurn fire into the stasis. Core JJ taken very low. Shurn going to be kept alive. Aphromoo the first to die. Core JJ going to follow him thereafter. It is one for one. Supports are out. And the shockwave finds nothing but air.
At least has the ability to blow up the wave.
But you had to make me a liar, man. Right then, right there.
Gold up, and they're pressuring bottom lane in him. Froggen makes his way back into the base.
He's two levels down on this rise. Jensen's level 17. Aphromoo's coming in from behind. This is a pretty big pick to make. Nice escape coming out from Jensen. Aphromoo doesn't want to chase this one down alone. But that means Team Liquid are now onto the Baron. They recognize the investment in the bottom side of the map made by Dignitas. The GP ulti not available. You can't just fire that into the pit here. And TL have ported Ryze in with the teleport.
Senate teams are slow at Baron, though. Look how slowly it's going down. They might contest.
Aphelios drops the Infernum with the Moonlight Vigil. Here we go. Grig going to be knocked out of the pit. Woo! Taken down. Doublelift able to find the secure. Core JJ tries to run away. Nice hook onto Shurnfire. It's going to find one pick, but Dig needs more than one.
Way too quickly. No way for TL to contest this one.
The Dark Harvest not really paying dividends here.
Not really.
Game as Rig tries to go in. Can they find the initiation they're looking for? Doublelift's going to get himself away. Core JJ now the target. Realm Warp's coming in. And that means you got to be careful. Grig is left for dead. Flashing over the wall to stay alive. Let's see if they stick with it, though. Grig is in the pit. The Baron down to one-third. Grig half HP. Damage over the wall coming in from Doublelift. Froggen is rooted up.
They're committed. I mean, Jensen just took the inhib, so
inhib is gone. You have to fight for this if you're Dignitas. Core JJ going to be there on the front line, having to flash away. Stoneplate keeping him alive. Nice ulti coming down onto two. Shurnfire going to be taken low. Froggen on a rampage. Core JJ gone. But Jensen is still in the base. Impact's being chased out. Dignitas has to fall back. Their base is under pressure.
Hooney trying to 50-50. It goes over. I mean, Shurnfire is low. Doublelift is in base. They're just rushing the Baron.
All right, they're trading Uber buff for Uber buff. Team Liquid going after the Baron, but Dignitas not willing to concede. It's Hooney
Explosions.
In the bottom lane. Could he be ready? It's Infernal Soul with Elder Drake. It's
going to
be
there.
Explosions and lasers and explosions and lasers. Ooh. It is secured by Shurnfire, who is immediately destroyed. Trade for junglers. Briggs over the wall, but he's taken down.
Unless Dig pulls off something just absolutely crazy.
I don't know if
Grig and Aphromoo coming in for the collapse, but Aphromoo's health just evaporates. Jensen walking away, but a nice shot comes out from Johnson, and the damage comes down.
Once Jensen is down, the split push does stop. Let's watch this again. I mean, it's not that complicated. It's EQ, EQ.
EQ, EQ.
Yeah.
EQ, EQ.
Yeah, he only needed the first two because he's done the other work. And then Froggen got enough.
Either way, it's a push coming up from Dignitas here in the mid lane. Doublelift is going to be forced to flash away. Core JJ under pressure now. Impact's taken into the Resurrection. Guardian Angel coming out there, but Doublelift. Wham, bam, that's the shot you need. Grig will now be slammed into the ground. And as Dig try to punish TL.
now the target. The Realm Warp used wonderfully for that. Jensen making full use of the Rise Kit here. Aphramoo finds a hook, but it's only onto Core JJ. Wriggling in, he's able to find the Cataclysm onto three. Damage going through, just shut down. Oh my goodness gracious! It's a double kill for Johnson. It's a team fight for Dig. Doublelift's looking to make some kind of a fight, but Grig will keep him busy. Stasis coming out, and D-Lift is the one man standing on the side of Team Liquid.
From one side to the other, now we're wondering if Dig can end, because Huni has been escorting that wave in the mid lane, and everyone on Dignitas is still alive. If he can keep those minions there, and they can stop this Doublelift recall,
The VIP minions, the name of the game for Dignitas.
Aphramoo's looking for him. If he can stop this recall, I think the game's over.
Aphramoo has to stop it. He doesn't get there in time. Doublelift makes his way back to the base. And how far will Dig go? It's 7 seconds on Core JJ. It is 8 on Schoenfire. The Dig push continues. The game ends here, one way or the other. Nexus turret's under fire. Core JJ and Doublelift looking to stop them. Damage coming through. Dignitas members, they've targeted the Nexus. They'll take it down. Team Liquid.
And Dignitas stays undefeated to start the year. Flowers, that was a back and forth battle. Dragon Soul, Elder Dragon, you were never sure if it was going to be enough. Ultimately, it was.
What a slugfest. It looked like Team Liquid were the ones getting the punish on Dignitas for trying to push the base too hard. But TL says, no, we can win the game right here. They go for the final inhibitor push, and as they're going to take that third inhib, Dig is swift, they make the strike, and that's exactly what I was talking about when I said I want to see these teams play confidently against Liquid. That was the Chad play right there. It was time to put up.